Hello, today we are going to make a couple of flags that involved triangles. Inflate a red balloon leaving about 8-inch flat tail. In this example, we're going to twist all bubbles of the same about 1-inch size. Twist a chain of the first 7 bubbles. Remarkably, to make the triangle shape, we're going to use fabric with square shape pattern. Basically, the same fabric that we already learned in some of the previously published instructions. In this example, optical illusion, or should I say pixelation effect, that what makes possible to use squares to make triangular shape. The long side of our triangle has 6 bubbles. Here we have made chain of first 7 bubbles. Now we lock both ends of the chain of the last 2 bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the long side of our triangle. Twist the next 2 bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 bubbles in one lock twist. We are working in the second row of our triangle. Twist the chain of the next 2 bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 10 bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the second row. Twist the next 12th bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 2 bubbles in one lock twist. We have to roll the 12th bubble around the 11th bubble. Once we done this lock, the last 2 bubbles would look a bit larger size than regular bubbles because of the pressure inside of the bubbles. So we should probably use smaller size bubbles just for this lock. Twist the chain of the next 2 bubbles. We have to lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 bubbles in one lock twist. There is no use for the rest of the balloon, so I'm going to cut off the rest of the balloon and tie off the end. Hold the last 2 bubbles, don't let them untwist. Make sure they have the same size. Now we have no difficulties to lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 bubbles in one lock twist. Congratulations, we have made the triangular shape. We use just one balloon to make it. The large side of triangle has 6 bubbles and the other 2 sides have 3 bubbles on each side. Not precisely triangular shape. Anyway, let's see what we can do with that. I'm going to use this red shape to represent a triangle in a Palestine flag. Tie nozzle of the black balloon between the 7th and 8th red bubbles. Twist a chain of the first 10 black bubbles. We are going to make a rectangular shaped flag with sides 6 by 9 bubbles. The long side of red triangle goes on the left side of the flag. It makes the first left column. And we will make the top row of our flag using 1 red and 8 black bubbles. Here we have made a chain of the first 10 black bubbles. Alright, let's lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 black bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the chain of the next 2 black bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 8 black bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the chain of the next 2 black bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 12 black bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the next, the last 15th black bubble. Cut off the rest of the black balloon, tie off the end. Lock the end of the 15th black bubble between the nearest 2 red bubbles. This way we make the second from the top row of our flag. So the second from the top row has 2 red and 7 black bubbles. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Also, as you may notice now, the red shape become more triangle-like. Working in the same fashion, just using different color balloon, we're going to fix the other corner of our triangle as well. But first, let's use a white balloon to make the third and fourth rows of our rectangle. Twist first white bubble. Lock the free end of the first white bubble between the nearest two black bubbles. It is the 13th and 14th black bubble. Tie the nozzle of the white balloon at the corner of the red rectangle. Twist the next two white bubbles. Lock the free end of the third white bubble between the 11th and 12th black bubbles. To make it a bit easier, we can unlock the black bubbles just to make more room to pull white balloon through. And then we lock the black bubbles back. We're using three red and six white bubbles to make the third and also to make the fourth row of this sculpture. In the same fashion, we work the rest of the sculpture. Here we have made the third row, and now we're moving to the fourth row. We will work the fourth row from the right side of the flag, moving to the left side. The rest of our sculpture we're going to work in exactly the same fashion. So I think we can first play the next part of the video clip. While you're working on the sculpture, take your time. You can always pause the video. In this example, I started the sculpture from top left corner. We actually can work the sculpture from any point, top, bottom, left, right. It is all up to you, your preferences. As you may remember from previously published instructions where we use the same kind of fabric to make sculptures, it is a bit easier to work two or more balloons at the same time. I purposely choose not to use this technique in this particular example. Probably we will do it in following examples. Of course, you can and always should work in the most convenient way for you. Okay, here we got to the last bubble. Congratulations, we have made rectangle with sides 6x9 bubbles. We use colors to represent flag of Palestine. In the following example, we're going to use the same size white triangular shape. One red and one blue balloon to make a rectangular shape with sides 6x8 bubbles. For this example, I choose colors to represent flag of Philippines. So let's tie nozzles of blue and red balloon at the center corner of the white triangle. Twist the first two bubbles. We're going to work both balloons at the same time. Lock the free end of the second blue bubble with the free end of the second red bubble. Basically, we're going to work the rest of the sculpture in the same fashion. It is quite easy to follow, so I'm going to first play this part of the video clip. We make the third row using five blue bubbles and three white bubbles. And then we move to the second row. In this example, I'm going to use one blue balloon to make total of 21 bubbles. It's also true with regards to the red balloon. If you want to use two blue balloons, then it takes just 18 blue bubbles to make the blue part of the rectangle. Here is the explanation of difference in numbers. Twist the 12th blue bubble, lock both ends of the chain of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. I don't want to cut balloon on parts, that's why I'm using the same technique as we did in triangular shape to move from one row to another row. Now we twist the next two blue bubbles, then we lock the free end of the 14th blue bubble between the first and the second white bubbles. We're already in the top row. And again, I don't want to cut the blue balloon on parts, so we have to move two bubbles back. Twist the 15th bubble, lock both ends of the chain of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. Now we have to twist the 16th bubble. And then we lock the end of the 16th bubble with the end of the 13th bubble. After that, we can work the rest of the row in a regular way. I'm going to first play the next part of the video. In this example, I'm going to use one blue balloon to make exactly 21 bubbles. If you have an extra part of blue balloon left, cut it off and tie off the end. And now we going back to the red balloon, work it in exactly the same fashion as we did the blue balloon. Take your time, do your best to use one red balloon to make exactly 21 bubbles. And it's okay if you don't have enough air in a balloon to make exactly 21 bubbles. You just have to use additional balloon or balloons to make whatever number of bubbles you have to make. In line of my work, I always try to use the least possible number of balloons to make almost any sculpture, but it's something that you don't have to stick with. Okay, here we are making the last red bubble. Cut off the rest of the red balloon, tie off the end, fix all bubbles in proper positions. Congratulations, we have made the rectangular shape with size 6 by 9 bubbles. Let's use a permanent yellow marker to draw symbols on the white triangle. It looks like I'm getting better skills in drawing and painting. Well, it's still far from perfection. Need more practice, I guess. Congratulations again, we have made the flag of Philippines. Let's take a look on both sculptures. You see the difference in the size here. In the following example, we are going to use two blue balloons to make larger size triangular shapes than we did previously. Twist the chain of the first 11 bubbles, lock both ends of the chain of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the large side of our triangle. Now we work the second row of our triangle in the same fashion as we did in previous examples. I'm going to use this balloon to make a total of 19 bubbles. Cut off the rest of the balloon, tie off the end. Our triangle will have 10 bubbles on the large side and 5 bubbles on each of the short sides. Use the second blue balloon to make the rest part of the triangular shape. Attach the nozzle of the second balloon between the last two bubbles of the second row. There is an easier way to do the same thing. Twist the first two bubbles. Lock the free end of the second bubble between two bubbles of the second pair. And after that, we attach the nozzle of the second blue balloon. Work the rest of the sculpture in the same fashion. We are going to use the second blue balloon to make total of, 14 bubbles. So let's do the math quickly. It takes two balloons, total of 33 bubbles to make triangular shape besides 10 bubbles by 5 bubbles by 5 bubbles. Okay, let's get back to our sculpture. Here we so far have made 6 bubbles of the third row. Now we have to twist the 7th bubble and then we lock the ends of the chain of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. Now we work on the fourth row. It takes 4 bubbles to make it. Twisting bubbles is a fast job. Connecting bubbles in a certain pattern, that's what really takes time. Later we're going to use this triangular shape to make flag of Puerto Rico. It would take more than 100 bubbles to make this sculpture. And so far we have made the fourth row of our triangular shape. Twist the 12th bubble, lock both ends of the chain of the last two bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the 13th and the 14th bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 bubbles in one lock twist. Cut off the rest of the balloon, tie off the end. Congratulations, we have made the triangular shape. In the following example, we're going to make a rectangular shape with sides 10 by 13 bubbles. Inflate 3 red and 2 white balloons. We use these colors to make flag of Puerto Rico. In this example, I'm going to use each balloon to make 2 rows. We have to twist 23 red bubbles to make the top 2 rows of the sculpture. Twist the chain of first 14 bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles and keep working in this fashion to make the second row. It could be a bit of a challenge to make 23 bubbles using just one balloon. If you run out of air in the balloon, simply attach additional balloon and work it to the end. With some practice you will twist 25 bubbles. Or who knows, maybe you will twist more than 28 bubbles using just one balloon. Okay, here we get to the last bubble of the second row. Lock the free end of the 23rd red bubble between nearest 2 blue bubbles. We have made top 2 rows. Depends on how you look on the sculpture, it could be bottom 2 rows. Now we're going to use white balloon to make the next 2 white rows. It would take 10 white bubbles to make the third row and then 9 white bubbles to make the fourth row. It takes total of 143 bubbles to make this sculpture, quite big sculpture. And most certainly it takes time to make this sculpture. As always, before you start your work on a big large size sculptures, make sure that you have enough balloons and time. Alright, so we have made the top 4 rows of our sculpture, and now we're going to make the bottom 4 rows. And again, we work the bottom 4 rows in exactly the same way, in the same fashion as we did the top 4 rows. I want to remind you, in this example we are making a rectangular shape with sides 10 by 13 bubbles. We use each red and white balloon to make 2 rows. Of course you can use one balloon to make just one row. Actually it is much easier and faster to use one balloon to make just one row. It is kind of funny, because usually the more balloons we use to make sculpture, the longer time it takes to make the sculpture. In this example, it works the other way. Okay, focus on the screen. Now we work 2 balloons at the same time to make the last 2 rows. Working in this fashion, we save time connecting balloons to each other. Depending on how fast you work with balloons and how you connect the bubbles to each other, it could take anywhere from 20 minutes up to 1 hour, I guess, to make this sculpture. With regards to Puerto Rico flag, this is example of so far smallest Puerto Rico flag that I have managed to make. Congratulations, we have made the rectangular shape with sides 10 by 13 bubbles. Now I'm going to use white correction liquid to draw a symbol, a 5-point star on a blue triangular shape. It is quite big star, so first I mark the 5 points, then connect them to outline the star, and then paint inside of the star. Also, I would suggest you to place the sculpture on some flat surface, like table or floor. It would be easier for you to paint. That's it. We have made the flag of Puerto Rico. Today we use only one kind of triangle to make all 3 sculptures. I still have to figure out ways to make different triangles with different angles. If you know different ways to make triangular shape, please share it in comments. Have fun and happy twisting!